Greetings, unsettled souls! Welcome to the correct views. Shall I be setting the last few of the changes for the show on the New Year set? How do you like the new set? We put it back together. One of the things we did is we've moved a fact cam over. I'm fixing the play recording devices for the live streamers. There is the set up. It is running again. There we go. Hello, live streamers. The set is up, running well again. We have moved fact cam over there because low def has fact cam via screen share. Not sure if all of the artwork that's up now is going to stay as the show progresses, but how do you like it? Not bad, not bad. We're going to get right into the news. This is brought to you by none other than D. Allen Ross, who is the author of a book called The Day the Lights Went Out. And I'll tell you what, if you haven't read it, make sure you do. He contacted me and I looked it up online, and I'm always looking for authors on the show. And he said that this was a humorous read, so I read it, and it is. So do yourself a favor and do the same. Make sure that you read it, and make sure that you tell other people about this story. How about that? Truthout.org. Seaborne Fukushima radiation plume hit West Coast. Corporate media reported it dangerously. Here's what's interesting to note about this. I had forgotten to mention it on the Fukushima show, and it was brought to my attention. I want to make sure that you guys understand that this is affecting the food that is coming into the country now. It's also affecting the lives of everyone on the West Coast. You can see this in the rise in cancer rates that are spiking up and down all over the West Coast. The kinds of cancers, unfortunately, that are actually associated with radiation, I might add. And you find this as well in terms of them saying that America is affected by Fukushima. Fukushima wasn't as bad as Chernobyl. Well, for one thing, it's worse. Second of all, Chernobyl wasn't something that would be used as a yardstick, as in anything less would be okay. Considering the birth defects that erupted in Belarus after it. Look that up someday. It is not a question anymore. Radiation produces cancer, and the evidence is good all the way down to the lowest doses, says the late John Goffman, professor emeritus at the University of California, Berkeley, in his book Nuclear Witness, Insiders Speak Out. Now, for those of you that know about the things that Michael Savage, the commentator, has done outside of radio commentary, well know that the California School of Berkeley is very astute with such things. On December 12, 2016, Enviro News U.S. Editor-in-Chief Emerson Urey touched off a firestorm with his new article, It's Finally Here, Radioactive Plume for Fukushima Makes Landfall on America's West Coast. We covered it. It claimed, it says, that medical science and epidemiological studies have demonstrated time and again that there is no safe amount of radiation for a living organism to be subjected to, period. Now, what does that mean? It means that all of the background radiation that you keep hearing about being so safe, that's not really true. Your routine releases that you see in nuclear power plants, those are not safe. These happen, as I've said 100 times, even when the plants are running properly. Look up the work of Dr. Helen Caldicott if you doubt me. If you doubt that doctor, look up Chris Busby. There are a lot of people to talk to you about this. Now, here's what some people don't realize. There is some question as to whether or not repeated microwave use causes cancer. A study that you can do in your own home is to buy 2 plants. Give one of them water, which comes only from the microwave, not while it's still boiling, and take another one and only give it water that has never been in the microwave, and inevitably the one that has had microwave water will die. That's problematic. Let's say that they claim that cell phones are safe because you're only, you know, you have what, 1-2 cell phones on you. Okay, what if you are a bus driver? What if you spend copious amounts of time on a train or an airplane? Maybe not an airplane because they're told to turn them off. But if you're around areas that always have maybe hundreds of thousands of cell phones on, like an office, is that healthy? This doctor is saying that such things are not. Now amplify that by something as large and as massive and daunting as the Fukushima disaster, which Chris Busby calls the worst disaster in human history. Multiply something as small as cell phones, which we have just shown could probably be somewhat dangerous, by about a billion, and you have some idea what Fukushima is. In this piece, Uri also exposed other news agencies like NBC and New York Post, USA Today, and The Inquisitor, catching them with their pants down in the act of repeating the false assertions of the US and Canadian researchers, telling people not to worry about recently detected low amounts of cesium-134 found in salmon, and that the levels were safe and the accepted threshold of human health. And let me ask you something. How is it that cesium-134, one of the most toxic elements known to man, I must have said on 100 times on the show, there's a reason the band who was going for a scary effect used that name. It's one of the most lethal toxins in the world. There is no safe amount. If I told you that I put a little bit of fecal matter in your fish, would you like to eat the fish? Well, don't you know that radiation in the levels that they're finding in it is far, far more lethal than eating defiled fish? I mean, I don't mean to be gross, but it's simply the truth. Tom Hartman picked up the article by Uri and read it on his show. Then Hartman offered up his own journalistic explanation on how radiation works and addressed the problem with the proclamation that there is a safe level of radiation to consume or be exposed to. And he starts talking about, as an element is decaying, it is throwing off radiation, and the radiation, if it hits your DNA in the nucleus and the nucleus of a cell, can alter your DNA in ways that can produce things like cancer, Hartman said. Now it can also cause simply the cell to die, or it can mutate the cell in all kinds of other weird ways. And so it's kind of a numbers game. If you irradiate 1 million cells, you might get 2 or 3 that become cancerous. That's all it takes, right? Bam, you've got cancer, Hartman continued in the video report. The cesium could cause no cancer, or it could cause cancer in the very first cell that it irradiates. To say that there is a safe level of radiation is frankly wrong. It's just wrong. Now, I hope that stands out to somebody. I hope someone's really listening to this, because Christelle is downstairs making turkey sandwiches before I begin my job at the Conservative Daily Post, where I write now. So am I talking to anybody? Is anybody listening, or is anybody paying any attention at all? If so, please leave a message in my comment line, because I happen to think that this matters very much. Uri said later in a statement, it's one thing for the media to regurgitate trivial facts on trivial matters, but to blindly repeat that consuming low levels of radiation is safe is irresponsible reporting, and it borders on dangerous. News editors, he writes, should take care to do their due diligence on a matter as serious as leading readers to believe consuming any amount of radiation is safe, when medical science and epidemiology dating back 50 years to present, we're talking about the writings of Einstein here, who helped, of course, dismantle the atom, have demonstrated repeatedly that that's just not true. Even the smallest exposures increase the risk of cancer to the subject. What about that somehow gets missed? More and more viewers coming in. Welcome aboard, friends. Nice to see you. According to the Agency for Toxic Substances and Disease Registries, they released a report entitled Public Health Statement for Cesium from 2004. Stable and radioactive cesium can enter your body from the food that you eat or the water that you drink, from the air you breathe, or from contact to your skin. When you eat, drink, breathe, or touch things containing cesium compounds that can easily be dissolved in water, cesium enters your blood and is carried to all parts of the body. No known taste or odor is associated with cesium compounds. It's a lot like potassium, so your body sometimes mimics, doesn't know the difference, which is why it latches on to larger fish. It said it eats and becomes more contaminated. In other words, it goes up the food chain. So the more seafood that a person eats, the more radioactive material that he or she is exposed to. It says the children, of course, are much more susceptible, which is something that I'm not entirely sure of, because I know that when you're an adult, your glands still, especially your thyroid, it still brings in as much potassium as it needs for the day, which is why it's important to keep your potassium levels high and your calcium levels high, because strontium many times will mimic, make sure I get this right, strontium many times will mimic calcium. Cesium will mimic potassium. That's why potassium iodide is so very important to have on hand in the event of a nuclear disaster. It can be very hard to get when a nuclear disaster is happening, so it's not good to wait. Those who might expect the government to protect them from contamination by radiation have only to look at the downwinder situation in Utah or the consequences of Goldman's research in the late 1960s. According to Goldman's obituary in the LA Times, Goldman and his colleagues at Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory, another source, Arthur R. Champlin, developed data in 1969 showing that the risk from low doses of radiation was 20 times higher than stated by the government. Now, isn't it interesting that everyone always talks about the dangers of not having enough government? Government needs to come in and protect me. Government lied to people and left them live in a poisoned area after doing bomb testings there. Hell, some of the people they told to watch the colors in the sky. In closing here, in an email, EnviroNews nuclear expert Arnie Gunderson said Japan had raised the maximum allowable level 20 times the previous number for civilians to be allowed into their homes. The U.S. and the EPA have considered such plans in the case of a nuclear accident. In food, the U.S. has allowable dosage of radiation that is 12 times what Japan allows. So, of course, we get a lot of Japanese food sent to us for the good of the bottom line. Isn't that just a wonderful thing to hear about? So don't tell me how government is going to swoop in like some amazing Batman and save us. Because that's not the case. People, we need the EPA and we need the EPA's regulations. Hello, many new listeners. Let me ask you something. The EPA, do we really need them that much if they're not standing up and if they're not stopping us from eating poison food from Fukushima? Then what good is the EPA? Useless. These things are best handled on a state level, and that is why the Constitution was written the way that it was. Friends, moving on, many people say that the answer to global warming, is nuclear fuel. Or even if there was global warming, which we're going to get to in a minute, the answer to warming of the planet is not to juice everybody with radioactive poisons from a nuclear power plant that spews radioactive toxins out even at a time that it's working properly. Second of all, the global warming thing is kind of, friends, obvious here to be a farce. USA Today. 10 to 15 feet of snow to bury California. Wintry weather also targets the South. Won't you look at this? Global warming. And of course now they're saying that because man is warming the planet, because of that, we're seeing colder winters. Why? Because they're being caught in their lie and they have to claw and scratch at anything to prove that you should keep paying your gas taxes like a good sheeple. A series of winter storms is forecast to continue hammering California with several feet of heavy snow and driving rain over the next few days and into the weekend. Good news for the drought-plagued state and for ski areas, but potentially bad news for travelers and homeowners worried about floods and mudslides. It can come to Ohio. I'm a snowboarder, and I'm dying here. Meanwhile, a storm could also spread a stripe of snow across the South, all the way from Texas to Virginia from late Thursday into Saturday. In the West, the combination of storms through this weekend has the potential to bring the biggest amount of rain and mountain snow to California since the drought began several years ago. Several feet of snow has already fallen in, say, Sierra Nevada from one storm, and several more feet is on the way from a second. More intense storm could hit over the weekend. Now, I'm not going to go ahead and go on and on and on and on and on here and bore everybody to death, but please stay with me. Trust me, I'm going somewhere. Southern snow. Any snow that falls in the South over the next few days will be measured in inches, not feet, but it doesn't take much to wreak chaos there. After one round of snow Thursday in the Ohio Valley and the Appalachians, more substantial snowfall could by Friday and Saturday end up in the South. Where? Oh, we're talking about places like Jackson, Mississippi, Birmingham, Alabama, Chattanooga, Tennessee, Atlanta, Charlotte, Winston-Salem, and Raleigh, and Richmond, Virginia. The potential exists for difficult driving. So, remember, friends, when they said, this is my point, remember when they said to us all that you're not going to have any more winters because of man-made global warming? You're going to have winters like you never had before. They're going to be colder, you dumbass! We have snow in record amounts, and we have snow in places that have never seen snow before, and you watching this are paying your gas taxes like a good sheeple. Think about it, friends. You want more proof? I can give you more proof. The Washington Post. Scientists say the global ocean circulation may be more vulnerable to shutdown than we have thought. Intense future climate change could have a far different impact on the world that current models predict, suggests thought-provoking new study just out in the journal Science Advances. Its atmospheric carbon dioxide concentrations were to double in the future. It finds a major ocean current, one that helps regulate climate and weather patterns all over the world, could collapse. The only thing wrong with this is they talk about times in the past that this kind of thing has happened before. Well, let me ask you something. What kinds of things caused this, you know, 1,000 years ago? It must have been the caveman with his big truck that he was driving, warming the planet, and it must have been the caveman with his industrial revolution technology that we all know he had, burning coal in copious amounts that led to this the last time. Because man is being blamed for it this time, and it doesn't make any damn sense at all. The one more I'm going to get to, this one is with the Conservative Daily Post. It's an article that I wrote for them, so I'm not going to go ahead and read the whole thing. I'm going to invite you to do so. It is, it's interesting in that I don't think anybody's reporting on these things as much as they need to be. The whole global warming hoax is falling apart. It says, liberals won't like the newfound evidence revealing that their man-made global warming is a hoax. And it says that it is being reported that a frigid burst of weather is due to absolutely punish the entire continent of North America, leaving only Florida free of ice and misery. While cold in winter is no more shocking than a dog that barks, what does stand out is just what this cold front actually means. I'm going to read you one more section of it. When the entire story is known, it comes to light that this winter is proving to be much colder than any winter that we have seen in the last 15 years. The global warming alarmists have been screaming from the housetops for decades about how there is not going to be any more winter. Now that winters have gotten much colder, they are forced to say that global warming is causing colder winters. Go on, read the rest of it, friends. Conservative Daily Post. It's my column there. I just begun working with them. And that is three stories in a row, and I count mine not because I'm using myself as a source, but because I used many sources in my article, to be clear. Global warming caused by man is not happening. Don't believe me? Fine, don't believe me. Look up Ward Monckton. Look up the fact that we... Look up planet hasn't warmed in 18 years. You'll find sources in science showing that this is the case. Look up the people who were stuck in the freaking ice. So they went ahead and they sent people to get them out of the ice, and they got stuck in the ice. Guess what the first boat was there for? To study the lack of ice! Is anyone listening to me at all? Maybe I'll start posting at this time all the time. I've got viewers everywhere. Welcome aboard, friend. Hit subscribe. God bless. USA Today, moving on to other news. We've got three stories left. Macy's is closing 68 stores. Job cuts total 10,100. Now, this is sad because it is a sign that America is bouncing away from its conventional past. The Macy's Day Parade, all of the things that were so very American. However, Macy's has brought a lot of this upon themselves. I remember my ex and I got a $50 gift certificate a number of years ago to Macy's, and we couldn't find one thing in the store to which we wanted to buy. It was just a bunch of stuff that none of us would ever wear or use, or, you know, like a $200 crock pot or something ridiculous. But this isn't good. It's too bad they couldn't have hung on longer to see if Trump maybe could have saved the economy a bit in a couple years with his administration. But in any event, after seeing sales drop during the holidays, Macy's said Wednesday it has either closed or will shutter 68 stores with an additional 6,200 position at a time when shoppers are going online to buy everything from scarves to lipstick. Out of the 68 stores, out of the 750 in total, 9 closings have been previously announced and 3 locations have already shut down. I'm not going to dwell on it. I'll lose listeners in droves, but I will say this. The left is trying to say that Obama is inheriting some wonderful economy here. Meanwhile, one of the department stores that have always been an icon in America is closing rapidly. And Christelle, during Black Friday, when we went, we didn't leave Thanksgiving for it. We're just up at those hours. We went and couldn't find anything at Macy's at all for anyone. We went in the store. She was wanting to skip it. So, I mean, it's not all a matter of online sales. Their stores have kind of crashed. Two more stories to get to you. This to you brought to you by Change Transportation. They're like Uber, only better. Call them. Look them up on Facebook, Change Transportation. WDTN.com. Woman says plane dumped human feces on her property. Having a crappy day in Salt Lake City, while many in Utah residents were busy cleaning up snow from their driveway. Bethany Bowker is busy trying to figure out how to clean up a snow mess. Yeah, a different kind of a mess. A human feces. It's disgusting, she said. But what was she going to say? It was brilliant. Around 3 p.m. on Tuesday, Bowker left to pick up her children at school. That's when she noticed a foul-smelling feces scattered all over her driveway in her car. At first, I thought, wow, some bird really took a dump on my car, Bowker said. It would have been a pterodactyl. She quickly realized that she wasn't dealing with fecal matter from the bird variety. This is undeniable, she said. She came to the conclusion it was human waste. Then she realized this isn't the first time that it's happened. It's happened before, but not to this extent. She recalls years ago seeing this kind of matter all over her property. She believes it came from a commercial aircraft releasing the waste from the air at the wrong time. They might have been flying low at the time, she asked. So does flying low mean you're going to dump crap all over? The FAA periodically receives reports of blue ice, frozen wastewater, falling on a house. If a person calls or sees it, they should call the FAA. Friends, that may sound dumb, but it is not the DUMBDEE of the day. No. The DUMBDEE of the day is far dumber. How many of you have believed that Merkel is a brilliant person who cares so very much about the people of the world? Well, if you believe that, you're going to find that that's not the case. Going into our idiot, dumdy part of the day, closing out. Man dresses as ISIS fighter and walks straight across German borders. A Danish citizen claims to have shown how pathetic the security is between German and Danish border. Now, this is important. This is really important because this is the kind of thing that Trump is trying to make sure does not happen here. You have a huge problem. Now, I'm not saying close the border down to people that genuinely need help. What I am saying is if you're going to allow the border to be open like Merkel is, then you need to make sure that the people, you have enough manpower to know who's coming there and why. And if you can't do that, then you may need to keep a better eye on how well your border security is really doing. And if not, if you fail to do so, then you will end up with something like this. A man dressed as an ISIS fighter with a fake gun and a terror network's flag claims in a video to have crossed the border several times. In his several alleged crossings back and forth between the two countries, not once is he stopped or questioned by authorities. The man is carrying a gun with an ISIS flag. He's wearing Christelle just bought me one for snowboarding. A baclava. In the video uploaded on YouTube, he has not been verified, and it is not clear exactly if it was when it was filmed. Or where. It comes almost a week after ISIS claimed responsibility for the Berlin terror attack, which claimed 12 lives. We covered that here as well as on Conservative Daily Post. Alongside the video, the uploader writes, a Danish citizen dressed in Islamic State gear, flag, and fake gun to show how pathetic the border in between Germany and Denmark is. We test our border controls. Can an ISIS terrorist cross the border unannounced? Border controls were non-existent. Do you feel comfortable with your open borders? There you go. You can. Those of you that are watching on the fact cam are seeing the proof of what he did there. Friends, it does make you wonder. I'm going to go ahead and just let the video here run without any sound. And you guys decide, is that the kind of America that you're going to feel safe with? If for some reason, live listeners, Google's not allowing me to screen share to you. Does that sound like a good idea to you? Because it doesn't to me. Friends, if you would like to donate, you can do so at thecorrectviews@hotmail.com. Every penny that you guys give to me, it goes towards a better show. I have a crappy camera, I have crappy lights. What I need is help from you to make a better show for all of you. I'm doing my best, and I need your help. So thecorrectviews@hotmail.com through PayPal does just that. Thank you for listening, because hitting share and hitting subscribe also does that. Retweeting does that. Letting people know that the show is out here and that the things that I'm saying matter, all of that helps, and I appreciate you for helping. Good night, friends. God bless, and thanks for listening.